Hey everyone, in today's video, I'm gonna show you ways that you can use Jamboard as an interactive whiteboard in your Google Meets. So right now, as teachers all around the world are trying to adapt to distance learning in a K-12 environment, one of the things I get asked about a lot is if there's any interactive whiteboards that you can use with Google Meet. Because teachers that work within a Google district don't really want to go to Zoom, but they like that Zoom has an interactive whiteboard. So what I'm going to show you today is one way that you can use Google Jamboard with your Google Meets. So if you haven't seen my videos on how to create a Google Meet and how to use Jamboard, you might want to pause this video and go watch those first. There are links in the description below, because this video is going to start off assuming that you know how to create a Meet and how to use Jamboard. Now what I'm going to show you is one way that you can use Jamboards within your Meet. Now I'm going to focus specifically on math today because a lot of the questions I get are from math teachers who want to show students how to do certain things and they want to see their students doing the work, but obviously this can be adapted to any subject area. Now the first thing you can do is you can write out your own equations. Now you're going to have to forgive my writing, I don't actually have a stylus on this computer that I'm using this, so you're going to have to just excuse how terrible this actually is. Ugh. But you get the idea that you can write out your own equations and then you can solve them below. Another thing you can do is you can find a worksheet that you want to take from. And if you use the snipping tool, you can go to New, create a little box around whatever work or equation or whatever it is that you want to take from, copy. Then you can go back into your Jam and paste it. And then you can see that you've got work in here that you can write underneath, you can write over it, and your students can watch you as you're doing this. So one of the ways that I personally would set this up if I was working with students in a live Meet environment is I would create separate frames for each student or for each group of students. So what I would do is I would create a second frame, and then, you know, again, you can copy and paste in equations. You could also do a sticky note. So if you didn't want to use your own handwriting, you could do something like 24 minus 10 equals 38 minus blank. And you could just have that posted. Or if you wanted, you could even put their names on it, or you could go ahead and create another sticky note with a different color and, you know, Dan, save. And then you can tell your students as you're going through, you know, your work is on the second one, why don't you work on that? And again, you're gonna have them do this right in your Meet. So again, you can do all this before you even get into the Meet. You could set up your Jam ahead of time. And then once you get into the Meet, what I would do is I would come in here, and again, my audio is gonna be a little bit off because I'm on two different computers here. But what I would do is I would present using my screen. Make sure you click on it, you see the blue box around it. Go to Share. And now they can see my screen and I can go up here and now everybody's watching as I show them how to solve this equation. So then, you know, you can go ahead and you can show them how to answer this. So you'd say like 42 plus 17 is 59. And you can do out all the math here, let them see that, and then walk them through and show them, okay, Dan, now I want you to try it on slide 2, so-and-so on slide 3. And again, it's all set up ahead of time. And then what you're able to do is you're able to see in real time how they are answering that. And then what I would do is I would go up to Share. I would either invite in my students or I would just take the link and change the settings to anybody with the link can. I want them to be able to edit and then save. And then what I would do is I'd go into my Meet and you could even share it right in the chat with everybody and say, okay, now I want you all to click on this Jamboard and go through, find the Jam, find the frame that has your work and begin to solve your equations. And then you can go in and you can watch as they're doing it. And again, they're all still listening while they have another tab open, so you can give them more instruction, work them through things, or have them present out if you wanted. You could have them go back and share their screens and tell you how they got their answers. So you really do have a lot of options with how you can use Jamboard, but I like it because it's keeping everything within the G Suite. It makes it easy. They're tools that the kids are familiar with. And again, it serves the same function. And the other thing I like about it, I'm just gonna switch off here because it's distracting, seeing my mouth not match up with my face, is that even after your meet, the students can still be working in here. And so the learning goes beyond the end of your virtual meeting. So again, this is just one way to use Jamboard with Meet. I know it's not perfect, but I really like the idea of keeping everything within the G Suite. I feel like right now teachers and students are dealing with a lot, just trying to adapt to the distance learning. And I know for a lot of students, they're being thrown a lot of different tools they've never seen before. They are probably pretty familiar with both of these. So it's one less thing that they have to learn. But if you're using both of these tools in a way that's even more effective than what I showed you today, please reach out, let me know in the comments below, or reach out to me on Twitter at Dan Spada. I'd absolutely love to hear about them and share it with other teachers because we are all in this distance learning thing together. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.